Avenue.
Shalom. All praises to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone. We back out here again. This is Columbus, Ohio. The city of filth. Anything you want to get started off with?
Oh, wow.
What's up?
Have mercy upon us, O Lord God of all, and behold us. Send thy fear upon all the nations that seek not after thee.
Right, yeah, because we pray to the Lord for mercy, you know what I'm saying, to save us out of this hellhole. Go ahead. And to save us from these heathen nations that's oppressing us.
Lift up thy hand against the strange nations, and let them see thy power. As thou hast, sanctifying us before them, so be thou magnified among them before us.
Right, they finna see the Lord's power. Alright, the Lord's gonna bring fire on these heathens. The Lord's gonna bring fire on America. Because America's really, you know, you got all these jakes living over here. This is the kingdom of Edom, kingdom of Satan. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
Let them know thee as we have known thee, and that there is no God but only thou, O God. Show new signs and make other strange wonders.
All right, just like during the Red Sea. We crossed the Red Sea, and all the heathens feared the power of Israel on that day because they knew about the Red Sea. They knew that really happened. And the Lord's going to do something. There's going to be a new Exodus. Go ahead. And then all the heathens, they're going to fear. And they all going to go into slavery. Because look, what happened after the Exodus? What did Joshua and Caleb do when they went up to the land of Canaan? They conquered, they destroyed, and they put all the heathens in slavery. Go ahead.
Glorify thy hand and thy right arm, that they set forth thy wondrous works. Raise up indignation and pour out wrath, take away the adversary and destroy the enemy.
Yeah, the Lord's going to destroy the enemy. Okay, go ahead.
Make the time short. Remember the covenant and let them declare thy wonders, the wonderful works.
Oh yeah, you're supposed to pray to the Lord comes immediately. You're not supposed to, like your boy, what's his name, Yakanan, he said that you don't know how long the Lord's going to take. It's going to be 8 months. He thinking he's going to be here for the next 10 years, you know what I mean? Because, you know, the Lord going to come tomorrow. We pray that he comes right now while we teach it. You know what I'm saying? We ain't planning our future 10 years in the future. Like, oh, we going, you know, 10 years, I'm going to have my bachelor's degree, and then I'm going to set up my retirement fund. Go ahead.
Make the time short. Remember the covenant and let them declare thy wonderful works.
Right, just like Romans 11 said what? You got to wake up out your sleep because time is short. Go ahead.
Let him that escapeth be consumed by the rage of the fire. And let them perish that oppress the people.
Right. Soon, two-thirds of Israel, of our people, they going to get consumed by that fire when the Lord brings them that fire to America. Because the Lord's going to destroy America by fire. Because soon those thermonuclear missiles are going to be launched, and all these cities and all these buildings are going to be turned into a pile of ashes. Ain't going to be no more America. Ain't going to be no more Columbus. Ain't going to be no more Coda bus stop. Ain't going to be no more State House. It's going to be all ashes. Go ahead.
Smite and thunder the heads of the rulers of the heathens that say there is no other but we.
Right, so all the rulers of the heathens, they going to get smitten. You know what I mean? Starting with all the senators, congressmen, they getting smitten, going into slavery. The Lord going to slap the shit out of them. See what I'm saying? The king of England, or the queen of England, the royal, so-called royal family in England, the Lord going to slap the shit out of them, and they're going to go into slavery. Go ahead.
Gather all the tribes of Jacob together and inherit thou them as from the beginning.
Right, so we spoke, that's why we out here right now to gather the elected Israel together, because Israel has been scattered among all nations, and that's why they need to be gathered. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
O Lord, have mercy upon the people that is called by thy name, and upon Israel, whom thou hast named thy firstborn.
Get right, because Israel's the firstborn. We was the, you know what I'm saying? Like, Adam was really an Israelite. He was the first man. And everybody on the earth comes from Adam. But not everybody that comes from Adam is of the chosen line, though. Because the Lord only came to save the nation of Israel. The Lord did not come to save all nations. He came for the nation of Israel, and that's it. Go ahead.
Oh, be merciful unto Jerusalem, for thy holy city, the place of thy rest. Build thine with thine unspeakable oracles, and thy people with thy glory. Give testimony to those that thou hast possessed from the beginning, and raise up prophets that have been in thy name. Reward them that wait for thee, and let thy prophets be found faithful.
Yeah, let the prophets be found faithful.
Joel 3 and 11. No. Let me start up one more. Joel 3 and 8. And I will sell your sons and your daughters. And I proclaim thee this among the Gentiles. Prepare war. Wake up the mighty men. Let all the men of war draw near. Let them come up. Beat your plowshares into swords, and your pruning hooks into spears. Let the weak say, I am strong. Assemble yourselves and come, all ye heathen, and gather yourselves together round about. Thither cause thy mighty ones to come down, O Lord. Let the heathen be awakened, and come up to the valley of the most pass. For there will I sit and judge all the heathen round about. Put ye in the sickle, for the harvest is ripe.
Yeah, the harvest is getting ripe. Now harvest is talking about people. As soon as on the Lord, there's gonna be a harvest. And the Lord, he's gonna come, when he send them angels, and the Lord gonna separate the wheat from the tares. He gonna separate the Israel from the heathen. And two-thirds from the elect. Because you got spiritual tares too. A lot of our people, they might be Israelites, but they still going to be destroyed. And they going to have to enter in the kingdom through reincarnation. They're not going to make it. They're going to be destroyed.
Yeah.
All the wheat. Because really, that's what's coming. Because what did the Lord say? He said, he sent us out to the harvest, and he told us that we're supposed to pray that the Lord send laborers to help us in the harvest. You know, what did it say? The harvest is many, but the laborers are few, something like that. So there's a lot of work to be done, and very few workers to do that work. You know what I mean? That's another reason you're supposed to go come out here and teach us. Oh yeah, it's a well-paying job too, ain't it? With the job, we got job offers open. It's got the best benefits, and it's the highest paying job you'll ever get. Because you got these fools out here in the world, what are they laboring for? They labor in vain. You know what I mean? Storing up their little material riches.
Yes.
Yeah, for it to get destroyed. Just like James said, you store up gold and all that, and it's just going to get melted. It's going to be destroyed. What is that? It's your gold and your silver is anchor. Go ahead. You got that?
Matthew 13 and 24 says, another parable put he forth into them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man which sowed good seed in his field. But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat and went his way. But when the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. So the servant of the householder came and said unto him, sir, it is not thou so good seed as I feel, but whence then have the tares? He said unto them, the enemy hath done this. The servant said unto him, look, thou then that go and gather them up. But he said, hey, that's why you gather up the tares and do up also the wheat with them.
All right, because like we said already, and we've been saying it, is that Israel is scattered among all nations, right? And that's why you got to let, see, because what did it say, the angels of the harvest? How did it say? Because you're going to have Israelites to look like heathens, and you're going to have heathens to look like Israelites. Everything's all mixed up. That's why the scriptures say to let the tares grow up with the wheat. You gotta wait till they both grown up, then the harvest is gonna come. Like we always said, like when you got a garden growing and you got weeds growing in your garden, you don't go pluck them up right away, because when a plant is so small, you can't tell what it is. You gotta let it grow up first, and then when you can tell what it is, then you pluck it. You know what I mean? When the harvest time has come, then you separate the wheat from the tares. Otherwise, you might thinking you are destroying some tares, but you really just... Go ahead.
As both grow together to the harvest, and in the time of harvest, I will say to the reapers, gather first the tares, bid them to bind them, and bundle to burn them, to gather the wheat to my barn.
Yeah, you got to do that. The wheat get gathered and put in the barn. When the barn, that's the kingdom. Go ahead.
Another parable for each corporate. Now stand, the kingdom of heaven is like to a grain of mustard seed, which a man took and sowed in his field, which is easy to leave the ball seed.
Right. Yeah, because a mustard seed is like real small, right? When you plant that little tiny seed, though, it grows until, you know, a big plant with flowers. Go ahead.
When it grows, it is greatest among herbs, and becomes a tree, so that the birds of air come and launch and drink grub. Another parable is that even to them, the kingdom of heaven.
But hold up real quick though, because that's what we doing. We come out here, we planting seeds, right? You might think people think what we doing is a small thing, but we plant that seed, and that seed is gonna grow. You know what I mean? It's gonna grow. We've been out here planting seeds for what? Going on what, 8 years? Which ain't nothing, you know what I'm saying? And you got the elders, they've been planting seeds. And then that tree's getting bigger and bigger, ain't it? Go ahead. Yeah, the tares pretty much, you know, a child of Satan. We're the children of the Most High. Two-thirds of Israel, you know, the children of the devil. And all the heathens, they the children of the devil. Go ahead.
The enemy that sold them is the devil, the harvest is the end of the world, and the reapers are the angels.
You're right, the reapers are the angels. And the harvest is the end of the world, which we're getting close to. Go ahead.
And therefore, the tares are gathered, burning in the fire, so shall it be in the end of this world.
Oh, hold on. I even seen that. What all the major news networks have been, you know, putting out stories about how Russia is getting ready to nuke America and all that. And I just seen another story put out today by Anonymous. You know, the hacktivists. And they warned that World War III is coming very soon. Because, you know, they're right on a lot of stuff. You know, because they be hacking into computers. You know what I mean? Well, go ahead.
The Son of Man shall send forth his angels, and they shall gather out of his kingdom all the things that have been. The Son of Man shall send forth his angels. They shall gather out of his kingdom all things that have been, and then will be the victory.
Yes. Yeah, so when the Lord returns to this earth with his angels, they're going to be running through this planet, man.
Swiftly.
Hey, we should get that Ezekiel and give an example of what the angels do.
Yeah.
That, what, Ezekiel 9?
Yeah.
Because it's going to be a replay of that. It's going to be worse than that. That ain't nothing compared to what's coming.
Foreheads of the men that sighed and that cried for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof.
Right, that's why we out here sighing and crying for all those abominations that's going on out here. And don't nobody follow the laws of the Most High no more. You know what I'm saying? You believe in the Bible, you get ridiculed, faggots get married. There's a weirdo everywhere you look. Left, look to the left, a fucking weirdo, the fucking weirdo to the right. You know what I mean?
And to the others he said in my hearing, go ye after him through the city, and smite, let not your eyes spare, neither have ye pity, slay utterly old and young, both maids and little children.
Right, so you think an angel's gonna care if it's an old wicked ass woman? She done committed adultery, she's 80 years old. On them 80 years of earth was spent in adultery, you know what I mean? So the angels is gonna destroy her, bro. So it's gonna be all there is to it. Ain't gonna be no mercy, go ahead.
Like utterly old and young, both maids and little children and women.
Yeah, but, even the little children are gonna be destroyed, go ahead.
But come not near any man upon whom is the mark, and begin at my sanctuary, then they begin at the ancient men.
Right, begin the sanctuary, because you got a lot of people who claim to be priests or prophets or whatever, and they teach them bullshit, teaching lies, and they deceiving the people. And that's like that wheat and the tares, because you got the spiritual tares among Israel, you know what I mean? And the devil came and sowed his seed. That's that seed that the devil sowed was wicked philosophies and wicked doctrines, teaching all nations can make it, or teaching, you got people. Cornelius and the Edomite. That's a demonic doctrine. By my fault, you know, people try to say mark of the beast. The mark of the beast is Christianity. That's one of those seeds that the devil sowed.
An embargo.
Saying the Lord's real name is Jesus Christ. You know what I mean? That's one of those seeds that the devil sowed. Go ahead.
And he said unto them, defile the house and fill the porch with the slain. Go ye forth, and they went forth and slew in the city.
They slew. There's some angels. Go ahead.
And it came to pass, while they were slaying them, and I was left, that I fell upon my face and cried and said, O Lord, power, wilt thou destroy all the residue of Israel in thy pouring out of thy fury upon Jerusalem? Then said he unto me, the iniquity of the house of Israel and Judah is exceedingly great.
It's exceedingly great. And you can see that too, can't you?
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. You know what? I've been hearing this. You hear this shit all the fucking time. Motherfuckers talking about beautiful black people. Where? Where? Where our people are beautiful? Where? You know what I'm saying?
You can't walk down the street at night without watching your back.
Right.
You got to creep in the shadows like a ninja just to stay safe. You know what I mean?
Our beautiful family. That's how you know a wicked nigga talking, man. You know?
Talking about the community.
Right. Let's build.
And they always talking about they going to clean up the community. Just, no, you're not. Look, the Lord is going to clean up the community.
Yeah, they can't clean up the curb.
Yeah. Goddamn trash all up in the street, all up in your yard.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? All our people care about is getting drunk. All they care about is having, you know, fucking and drinking and getting high as fuck. I was talking to this Jake last night. He was high with that. Some meat. I was like, what the hell are you high on? He was like, what the hell are you saying? And he was doing this. Just leaning. He was gone.
This was just look dope anyway, man. I was watching a video this morning, the old American Bastard wrestler.
Yeah.
And it was just 88, 89. And it was showing Sting.
That's a good ship back in them days.
Yeah, it was shooting steam. The Road Warriors.
All-American band?
Yeah.
I know Ric Flair's there.
It was all of them all in the locker room.
Yeah.
Snorting cocaine, man. On camera.
Really?
Yeah, I just found it this morning.
Is that part of that was just behind the scenes?
Yeah.
Shit.
Behind the scenes in the locker room kicking it. They ain't have the uniform. They ain't have the makeup on and shit. But Jacobs was getting, you know them Jakes, man. The motherfuckers just getting snorted the fuck up, man.
They got to. Hey, well, they don't have to.
It's just coming out now. You know what I'm saying?
But, hey, one of my favorite wrestlers, New Jack. New Jack, he was famous for jumping off high-ass ledges and hitting people with elbows, jumping, 30 feet high and crashing through tables. And they asked him if he did cocaine before he matched. He's like, do you see what I do? He's like, what the fuck do you think?
Right.
You gotta be high to do that crazy-ass shit.
Yeah, right.
Hey, but in the kingdom, we're gonna have spiritual power. We'll be able to hit your ass with an elbow or a leg drop from 50 feet in the air. You know what I mean? We're gonna have power. We won't even get hurt.
But we're bringing it. We're uncovering. They cover. We uncover. Then see he unto me, the iniquity of the house of Israel and Judah is exceedingly great, and the land is full of blood, and the city full of perverseness.
Yeah, that's all you see out here is perverseness, man. Ain't nobody trying to walk in the light. They choose to walk that path of darkness.
Sweet darkness.
You know what I mean? That's their comfort zone, is wickedness. Yeah, that's what they say too. It's like the Lord ain't—he forsaken the earth. He ain't coming back. He ain't even worried about us. I was reading a comment on the YouTube comment board today. Somebody said something like, "Well, the earth is only a tiny speck in the grand scope of the whole universe. You think God's worried about us? You know?"
That's their logic.
That's Esau's philosophy, actually. That devil Carl Sagan wrote a book called Pale Blue Dot. The cover of the book was just the earth as a little itty bitty dot. He was trying to say that, you know, we're insignificant. And if there is a God, he's not worried about us. Okay. Yeah, that's that bullshit. And he was a so-called Jew, Carl Sagan. So, you know, he had an agenda when he wrote the book.
And for me also, my eye shall, and as for me also, my eye shall not spare, neither will I have pity, but I will recompense their way upon their head.
On their head.
And behold, the man clothed with linen, which had the inkling by his side, recorded the matter, saying, I have done as thou hast commanded me.
Right.
Find this other precept real quick. People just don't understand, man.
But you know, they say that angels ain't real anyway, so you know, that's that spook shit. So. Y'all figure it out. Watch. You'll see. When it's too late, y'all have it figured out.
Yeah, when it's too late. That's when that salty
feeling
takes
off. Oh, there's gonna be salt on that day.
of God, which made all things such as out all hidden things and secrets to earth. Truly he knows your visions and what you see in your heart, even them that sin and continue to hide themselves. Therefore have the Lord exactly search out all your works, and he will put you to all to shame. And when your sins are brought forth, you shall be ashamed before men, and your own sins shall be your people in that day.
And your sins are brought forth. You're going to bring some shit to light. Publicly embarrassed, you know, shame on camera, you know what I'm saying? You know how to goddamn devil with their damn cameras, channel 4, 6, and 10, like to float around everywhere doing nothing. Somehow they just come out of nowhere, man. Wait a minute, like the ones that when they caught the
dude
on the freeway who got flipped out the car and ended up on the side, he was made a public example out of it. So, most of it, man, it's amazing how, you know, we can't even imagine what he's going to do to, you know, bring this shit out, man. Some of these motherfuckers gonna get caught taking that run up the rear, you know what I'm saying? And it's gonna accidentally crunch or something in there, and they're gonna have to go to the hospital. You know, people in the hospital be laughing at these people sometimes when they come into certain shit, man. They turn around, they go to the other room, they be talking to each other and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? It's embarrassing, man. But these people ain't got no conscience, man, because they ain't never been called out on, you know? Because the shit's all good. The shit's all good. Wicked ass motherfucker. Just like dude, the doctor. Remember the doctor ran into the girl's boyfriend over there?
Yeah, yeah.
He called him out in public. You know what I'm saying? He never thought that was gonna happen, man. He never seen that coming, man.
They got caught.
Right. Oh, a doctor. He couldn't say shit. Cause ain't no defense for a doctor, man.
Nah, man. That's one of the most wickedest things a man can do is commit adultery.
That's a shameful act.
Adultery, that's on par with murder.
Right.
That's why a murderer and adulterer both have the same punishment in the Bible, which is death.
Homosexuality, same shit.
That's all right, though, because, you know, the Lord said there'd be a great falling away first, you know what I mean? You can see it.
Oh, yeah, that's the moment.
They done fell way away. That's why y'all called the Nephilim. Nephilim is Israel, the fallen one. That's why people, they don't fell off a goddamn cliff landing right on top of their head. I mean, just adulterers, thieves, you can't let nobody in your house no more. You know what I'm saying? Come up missing, you know what I mean?
Six, Mount Vernon to the VA clinic.
You need that?
I was just about to get that Thessalonians on deck.
Oh,
go ahead, read it.
Thessalonians 2, this is 2 Thessalonians 2 and 2, that ye be not soon shaken in mind or be troubled.
And we should start at 1 and 8, not 1 and 7, and read all the way down. You know what I mean? Where you at? 2
Thessalonians?
2 Thessalonians 1 and 7? Because it talks about the fire.
One.
Yeah. No, 2 Thessalonians chapter 1.
No. 2 Thessalonians. What you want?
2
Thessalonians. 2 Thessalonians.
2.
You want 2 Thessalonians?
He was in 2.
Right. I was in 2 Thessalonians 2.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because you can read all, because it goes right into
it. I also started 1, though. I also started the top.
Oh, yeah, we can do that. That's good. It doesn't matter. Because there's so much fire in there, though. Like, literal fires right here.
Right. Here you go. 2 Thessalonians 1, 2 and 1. Now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord, Yahushua, Mashiach, and by our gathering together unto him, that ye be not soon shaken in mind, or be troubled, neither by spirit nor by the word, nor by letters, as from us, as that day, as the day of Mahashiach is at hand, let no man deceive you by any means. For that day shall not come, except there come a falling away.